It's an age of abundance and abject poverty. Globalization and technological advances enable us to converse across the continents. Yet, we often do not know who our next door neighbors are. Markets overflow with goods, but hearts are emptier than ever. In a world full of such contradictions, can an ordinary individual make any difference and take initiatives of change? The answer is yes. Nestling in the hills of Panchgani and overlooking the Krishna Valley lies Asia Plateau. The training and conference center of moral rearmament.
Moral rearmament is a worldwide fellowship which believes that every individual has a unique contribution to make to the transformation needed in the world, starting with one's own self. It believes that a new world begins to take shape when an individual finds an answer in his own life to bitterness and apathy, lust and greed. We believe better people will create a better world.
In 1963, Rajmohan Gandhi and his colleagues led a nationwide march calling for a clean, strong and united India. Camps were held to train young people. One was held in Panchgani, after which the local citizens invited them to establish a permanent center here. With only barren land, hard rocks, a few bushes and just 1800 rupees in the account, the construction started. The first contribution came from a widow in Pune who gave 10,000 rupees, half the capital left by her husband. An Australian architect designed this complex free of charge as his contribution. He travelled to India 17 times at his own cost. Thousands contributed in cash and kind. In 1968, the first building, Valley View, was inaugurated. The second, Rock View, came up in 1969. These buildings can accommodate 200 people.
The main complex, inaugurated in 1973, has a kitchen, dining halls, conference halls, lounges, a prayer room and an auditorium. The total cost of the auditorium was divided by the number of seats, and all the 395 seats were named according to the wishes of those who raised that amount. Frederick Phillips inaugurated the main complex. The electronic sound system, light fittings, and simultaneous translation system were gifted by his company. Where once was a single silver oak tree, now stands a dense forest, a home to 85 species of birds. Panchgani lies in a rain shadow area. Water conservation is vital. The roadside bunds prevent soil erosion. Trees increase the underground water table. Sewer water is recycled. Rainwater collected from roofs and stored in underground tanks provides sufficient drinking water for the entire year. Kitchen waste is converted into compost. Solar panels provide part of the hot water. Natural light illuminates the kitchen through translucent ceiling panels. Energy saved is energy generated.
Round the year, Asia Plateau holds dialogues, conferences, and training programs for industry, army, educators, families, youth, and children.
Every time we visit Asia Plateau, we have discovered something different in others as well as in ourselves. And we have hope that someday the people who are trained at Asia Plateau will govern this country.
Youth is the sapling of my nation. Each one is a sapling. Millions of trees are, these are saplings, saplings of youth. If we nurture them well, if we water them well, if we give them the right sunshine, we give them the right protection, we give them the right manure, which is education and ethics, we'll have a forest of good and rich trees. That's what MRA is all about. It's building and nurturing right saplings.
In my 25 years of experience in management education, I have found that the students are so busy with their activities that they really have no time to sit back and think as to where they are headed for in life, what their long-term goals are. To that extent, the programs to which our students have been going at the Asia Plateau have come in as an extremely welcome interlude. The discussions on ethics, principles of life, how to manage in a very, very truthful way your business has provided the software of life as against the hardware which we provide in the form of education.
Indian culture believes in Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam. The world is one family. Asia Plateau also believes in thinking of and caring for the whole world. International conferences on agriculture, human rights, developmental issues, role of women in peace building and reconciliation are also held.
The whole atmosphere of Asia Plateau, with its beauty, landscape and buildings, is unobtrusive and seems to be a part of nature, which gives me peace of mind. Harmony between nature and a human mind is very important. The uniqueness of Asia Plateau is that it offers spiritual strength and wisdom to grow in character.
An interesting aspect of all these programs is the way participants take on practical work. If you wish to participate in any such program, you can get the relevant information by subscribing to Disha, a quarterly in-house newsletter.
How does one begin? Perhaps you can go to a quiet spot and measure your life against the highest human values like honesty, purity, unselfishness, and love. Introspect. Have you been dishonest? Do you cheat on your taxes or in expense vouchers? Do you do fair day's work for a fair day's wage? Are there any addictions that rule your life? Do you care enough for your family, your colleagues? Are you bitter towards anyone or just feel divided from or indifferent towards? Reflect on all the instances where your behavior does not match with the values that you expect to find in society. Then try and see how you can put things right. Apology and restitution are important.
This experience of personal change gives one hope that things can change. It liberates and empowers one to pass on this spirit to others. It is this candle of vision and faith that Asia Plateau strives to light in every heart. It makes one part of the cure, then remain part of the disease. Asia Plateau also helps individuals to become sensitive to their own awakened conscience, one's inner voice. The time of silence helps us think clearly, gives us the time and space to evolve, encourages the habit of listening, which is vital for a meaningful dialogue.
Here I found a cure for the deadly bitterness towards my professor, which had clouded my vision and my love for the country. A simple letter of apology freed me from that preoccupation. That enabled me to launch a consumer association for health and for ethics in the medical profession, to promote breastfeeding throughout the world, to write books on child care, and to start an organization against corruption. All this besides my continuing busy medical practice.
After the demolition of Babri Masjid, riots broke out in Mumbai. I was particularly upset after reading a report about children suffering from thalassemia being sent away from hospitals due to shortage of blood. As an ordinary housewife, I felt helpless, but I had a thought. I arranged a blood donation camp in our locality, which was never done before. People were ready to give cash, but not blood. On the actual day of the camp, one-third households turned up to donate blood. This changed the atmosphere completely.
When I left my village and went to the city for higher studies, people there behaved very badly. I hated them. I stopped studying and joined a political group propagating a policy of hate. The idea of violence not only affected my group, but also my village and family. In my village, there were two political parties. Because of the division between the leader of the other party and myself, the development work had stopped. I realized I was blocking the development of my own area. I apologized to him, and today we work together. We established the first school in our area. I also took initiative in digging fish ponds and making our village self-sufficient.
A leading Indian newspaper called Asia Plateau a beacon of hope. It is open to everyone, everywhere, irrespective of status, caste, race, or religion. It empowers every individual to take initiatives of change.
What attracts me about the Asia Plateau is the belief that all change starts from
changing yourself. I think we have got so used to blaming others, be it the government, anybody but myself. And I think this emphasis that you begin with yourself is a very beautiful idea, and I subscribe to it. I also like the idea of silence. You need some time to reflect. And of course, the beautiful surroundings, that's another thing that's beautiful about Asia Plateau. The very loving, systematic way they care for each of you. So these are some of the things that attract me to the Asia Plateau.
Asia Plateau is also a launching pad for creative ideas. Asia will be known not for the blasts of bombs, nor for the cry of suffering, but for the still small voice that speaks in every heart. Got by this conviction, 50 young men and women from 15 countries wrote and produced a stage production, Song of Asia. In songs, dance, drama and humor, it portrayed true stories based on change in the lives of men. Thousands throughout India, Laos, Vietnam, Canada and in Europe saw it.
His Holiness the Dalai Lama inaugurated one of the conferences at Asia Plateau. His vision is, if the 20th century was one of war and conflict, could the 21st century be one of dialogue? Asia Plateau is owned by Friends of Moral Rearmament India, a public charitable trust. But anyone who senses an inner urge to associate with its endeavors is needed.
Asia Plateau believes that each one of us can make a difference, and together we can make it felt. We invite you in this effort to create a cleaner, calmer, fairer world.